Hello and welcome to my latest leaders briefing. I'm here today in Dronfield Sports Centre where we've had some fantastic news. We've recently been awarded a grant of around £1.4 million from the government to help make Dronfield one of the first existing facilities to be converted into a carbon neutral building. It's amazing news. It's a real important part of our journey to net zero, and it's going to mean some real improvements for Dronfield Sports Centre in terms of those carbon emissions and helping with our energy bills, which I know we're all feeling the pinch on. So fantastic news here from Dronfield to begin with. And sticking with the theme of Dronfield, we also recently held a deaf engagement event from our sports centre here, where we invited members of the deaf community to come and talk to us and talk about our services and hear feedback from them. So I just want to say a big thank you to everyone who joined us for that event. Really do appreciate it, and we'll look forward to more of those events over the coming months. Moving on to some more fantastic news, I'm really, really proud of the fact that North East Derbyshire District Council has recently been awarded the Ministry of Defence's Gold Award as part of its employer recognition scheme. We're one of only about 550 employers in the country out of around 7 million employers to have been awarded this award, and it really is a fantastic achievement, and it's all part of our commitment to the armed forces and to supporting members of the armed forces, whether that's veterans or reservists or cadets, and it's really, really a fantastic achievement, and I'm really proud of the council, and thank you to everyone from within the council who's been working so hard to achieve that. And on the topic of the armed forces, I'm really pleased to say that our new chair of the council, Councillor Diana Ruff's charity for the year is SAFA, which is the Armed Forces charity. Now hopefully you'll see more of her events over the course of this year, and you'll be able to support those, because all of her fantastic work over the course of the year is going to be contributing to the Armed Forces community through the charity of SAFA. And on that note, I also want to pay a huge thank you and a big well done to Councillor Martin Thacker, who raised an absolutely record-breaking £79,500 for Ashgate Hospice Care during his previous year as Chair of the Council. Really, really well done to Councillor Thacker, and thank you again to everyone who supported that cause over the course of the past year, who attended some of those events or made donations or supported in lots of different ways. It really is a fantastic achievement, so well done to Martin. Moving on, I'm really pleased to say that we held a jobs fair in Homewood recently, and I want to say a big thank you to everyone who joined us for that event and took part in it, and all of the employers who had stalls there as well. We're actually hosting another one of those events here at Dronfield Sports Centre on the 29th of September, and it's really important to us as a council to help local people find local jobs in North East Derbyshire, and that's a great way to do so. So if you're looking for work at the moment, please do look out for that event. On another issue that I know we're all feeling the pinch on is the cost of living crisis at the moment, and together with Derbyshire County Council we're doing a lot of work to try and collate information and advice for people on how they can manage issues like rising energy bill costs and all of those sorts of things. So please do go on our website and we can direct you to some of those resources to try and support you, and obviously the government is doing a lot around trying to support people with payments towards energy bills and all of those sorts of things, and all of that information around what the government is doing as well as what we're doing locally as councils you can find on the website. So please do look on our website and find out more there. Now moving on, we've recently prosecuted someone in Dronfield for the crime of fly tipping. We're really pleased that made it to court and the person was sentenced and ordered to pay a fine, and we hope that will be an important deterrent for anyone else thinking about fly tipping in the district. We take a really, really dim view of that, and we really want to push as much as we can, and our environmental health team do a fantastic job in pursuing those leads and really cracking down and doing all that we can to send the message that it's just simply not good enough to be fly tipping in North East Derbyshire. Another issue that I'm afraid to say we faced recently is a lorry fire on one of our recycling lorries in Unston recently, and we believe it was caused by a battery that was placed within the recycling. We're asking residents to really be careful about what they do put in the recycling. Obviously, it goes without saying we want everyone to recycle as much as possible, but if you're ever unsure about what should or shouldn't go in the recycling containers, then please do go on our website. There's loads of information there. We're doing a lot to try and educate the public around what we should recycle and what we shouldn't, and we just don't want to avoid any issues like that again in future. So please do, if unsure, go on the website, have a look and just double check. We've also had the really good news recently that our campaign, together with our local MP Lee Rowley and the County Council and the Sheffield City Region, to get the Barrow Hill railway line reopened for passenger transport. We've recently heard that that's gone to the next stage. It's part of the government's Restoring Your Railway Fund, and we've gone from quite a big long list now down to the final few stages of a short list. And what it means is now that we can progress to the next stage of a much more detailed business case to demonstrate to the government that it really is a worthwhile opportunity and that there'll be a significant economic growth out of doing this. And so although there's still a lot of work to go, it's looking really positive around the Barrow Hill line and reopening that. And we think that's a great opportunity for the district. It could potentially mean new stations in areas like Eckington and Killamarsh, and give that better access to both Chesterfield and to Sheffield. It has all of the greater benefits around climate emissions as well, in terms of reducing car journeys and all of those sorts of things. So there's a huge number of benefits that could come with this, and we're really pleased that the campaign's edging ever so closer now to getting the nod and getting the agreement to go ahead with that. And we'll keep everyone posted, obviously, through our website moving forward as to how those plans progress and whether we get through to the very few final stages and importantly get the go ahead from the government. You've probably heard this before in my previous leaders briefings, but I just want to push once again our community action grants. Now, these are grants of £500 to any community group locally within the district, and it's to help with a wide variety of things, from organising events or planning activities, anything that helps local communities try and deal with some of the local issues that they have in their area, or to get communities to come back together following COVID, all of those sorts of things. There's a huge amount of information on our website, and you know, we've funded lots of different groups already, and you'll be able to find out about some of the other groups that have received funding and the ideas that they had. So please do check out our website if you're interested, if you'd like to know more, and possibly, hopefully, we'll be able to fund your projects over the coming weeks and months. And finally, as we approach the end of the school term now, I know myself as a parent how frightening it can be trying to plan for the 6-week summer holiday and keeping your kids entertained. So we're asking residents to check out our recent Neddy News magazine that we put out for you through your letterboxes. There's tons of activities in there, free activities that we can all do around both the district and a bit further afield. Also check out what's going on at our leisure centres. There's always a huge amount of activity for young people there. And if in doubt, always go on our website, because there's always plenty of information there about things that we have going on. And hopefully that will help you to plan out your activities and plan your summer holiday, and it can be as relatively stress-free as possible. And finally, thank you very much for listening in to the Leaders Briefing today. Hope you found it useful and informative. And obviously, if there's any other queries you have or you want to find out any more information, please do follow our Facebook channels, follow our Twitter channels, all of the social media channels, and go on our website for more information. We're always updating it regularly to keep residents posted. And obviously, if you've got any ideas for future topics you want me to cover, do get in touch with me.